ॐ विश्वस्मै नमः। ॐ विष्णवे नमः। ॐ आदिदेवाय नमः। ॐ अनादिनिधनाय नमः। ॐ भूतमहेश्वराय नमः। ॐ भूतभव्यभवत्प्रभवे नमः। ॐ भूतभव्यभवत्नाथाय नमः। ॐ सर्वलक्षणलक्षण्याय नमः। ॐ पुण्यश्रवणकीर्तनाय नमः। ॐ सत्यधर्मपराक्रमाय नमः। ॐ सत्यधर्मपरायणाय नमः। वर्स 35 श्री विष्णु सहस्रनामा। अच्युतः प्रदितः प्राणः प्राणदो वासवानुजः अपां निधिः अधिष्ठानम् अप्रमत्तः प्रतिष्ठितः। अच्युतः प्रदितः प्राणः प्राणदः वासवानुजः अपां निधिः अधिष्ठानः अप्रमत्तः प्रतिष्ठितः। ॐ अच्युताय नमः। ॐ प्रतिताय नमः। ॐ प्राणाय नमः। ॐ प्राणदाय नमः। ॐ वासवानुजाय नमः। ॐ अपां निधये नमः। ॐ अधिष्ठानाय नमः। ॐ अप्रमत्ताय नमः। ॐ प्रतिष्ठिताय नमः। अच्युतः वन ऑफ द मोस्ट पॉपुलर नेम्स ऑफ महाविष्णु। अच्युतः मीन्स वन हू हैज नो च्युति। च्युति मीन्स फॉलिंग डाउन। च्युति कैन मीन मॉडिफिकेशंस to which all living beings are subject, like birth, growth, decay, disease, and death. The Supreme is one who is without any such chuti, chutam. So he is called Achyutaha. Achyutaha is eternal and immutable. It cannot have any change. The Self, being the eternal, cannot have any of the changes that are inevitable in the case of all mortal and finite beings. Supreme is immortal and infinite. Upanishads therefore proclaim Mahavishnu as the eternal, the auspicious, and the changeless, that is Shashvatam, Shivam, Achyutam. Bhagavad Gita declares in verse 30 of chapter 6, Dhyana Yoga, also known as Atma Samyama Yoga. Yomam Pashyati Sarvatra Sarvancha Mayi Pashyati Tasyaham Tasya Aham Napranashyami Sachame Napranashyati. For him, the great devotee who sees me in all the beings and sees all beings in me, to such a great devotee, I am not ever lost to him, nor is he ever lost to me. The eternal, the auspicious, and the changeless supreme is therefore very well known and very famous, that is Pratitaha. He is famous, he is well known, his glory has been proclaimed repeatedly in the Vedas and Upanishads. He is the one who exists everywhere. He is all pervasive. He spreads himself everywhere. That is why he is called Vishnuho. Vishnuho is one who spreads anywhere, who is all pervasive. Such a supreme being is very life breath, prana. Pranaha is the very life breath of all the beings. He is the one who, in the form of vital air, Prana Shakti, sustains life in all creatures. Once the life breath leaves the body, the person becomes a dead body. So, the life breath itself is the Mahavishnu. He is also called Prana Devata. Hanumanji is also well known as Prana Devata. He being son of Vayu is called Prana Devata, Mukhya Prana. He is the Prana, he is the life force in all living creatures, which means that it is his manifestations that we recognize as the endless activities in all living creatures in this dynamic world. When any person is acting through any of these senses, that means that itself is one manifestation of life, that is manifestation of the presence of the Supreme Being in that particular body. Only then the body is called a Jiva. Otherwise, it is a Mruta. The Supreme Being, the very life breath of all the beings, he is also not only the Prana, but he is also the giver of Prana. How do we get this Prana? It is only because he has given that Prana to us. He is the life giver. Here, Da has two meanings. Da means give, a giver. It also means, it also denotes destruction. This is very strange. How can you associate Paramatma with destruction? Yes, we can, provided we have in mind destruction of the negative qualities, destruction of our weaknesses, destruction of the lower impulses. So, Mahavishnu is the one who gives strength and glory for the Devas. He is the one who supplies special strength to them to win over the forces of the wicked Asuras. Now the same thing can be interpreted at our level. The Supreme is giving us the mental strength for cultivating higher values of life. The same divine source, it is providing the seekers, the devotees, the courage to annihilate, to destroy the lower impulses. Because these are the lower impulses which in turn destroy the peace and tranquility of human beings. That way, Supreme is doing great service by giving us this power of destruction also. Such a great being, the giver of life to all, has manifested himself as younger brother of Indra. Vasava Anujaha. Vasava is Indra, Anujaha, younger brother. Vasava Anujaha, younger brother of Indra. The Lord Vishnu was born to Mother Aditi as her son for the purpose of tackling Bali, Maharaja Bali, the great Bali, Mahabali, who had captured the Swarga and displaced Indra. To help Indra, Mahavishnu was born as his younger brother, and as a small adorable dwarf, he was called Vamana. And this Vamana later conquered all the three worlds within three strides of his. Once he transformed himself into Virat Rupa, and then he helps Indra to regain his throne. Now Indra has one more meaning. Indra also means mind. This one who is the lord of the senses, called it, is the mind, it can also be called as Indra. Indra denotes. Now, when Vishnu is considered to be younger brother of Indra, it means here, it denotes the spiritual earth in us, which acts like a younger brother of the mind and helps us ultimately to win over the three worlds within us. Vamana won over the three worlds, earth, heaven, swarga, patala, all the three he was able to conquer. But in terms of our own realm, these three worlds are the state of waking, the state of dream, and state of deep sleep. We are able to conquer all this with the help of our spiritual urge in us, which is nothing but the Supreme Being. The Vamana who conquered the three worlds in three strides in his all-pervasive and expansive form, he is also expansive like the mighty ocean. Apam Nidhi. So Vishnu is described by the term ocean. Ocean is a treasure of waters. Apam Nidhi means treasure of waters, which means the ocean. The very glory and might of the oceans, what are they? They are nothing but a reflection of Vishnu's own glory. In Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Sri Krishna declares, among the collections of water, I am the ocean. Water can be found in different places, maybe a small pond, a small vessel, a mighty lake, a giant flowing river, and also the ocean. Among all these water bodies, Krishna says, I am the ocean. Because Krishna was explaining, trying to make Arjuna understand the superlative nature of his personality. That verse is verse 24 of chapter 10 of Bhagavad Gita, Vibhuti Yoga. It reads, Puro dasam cha mukhyam maam vidhipartha sanatanim vidhipartha bruhaspatim puro dasam cha mukhyam maam vidhipartha bruhaspatim enaninam aham skandaha sarasam asmi sagaraha. Among the priests, I am the, oh Arjuna, understand, Vidhi Partha, Partha, you understand that I am among the priests, I am Bhaspati, the priest of the gods. Among all types of commanders, I am Skanda, the commander of the army of the Devas. Among the water bodies, I am Sagaraha, Sarasan Asmi Sagaraha. The all-pervasive and expansive Supreme is the substratum, the sole support of the universe. It's called Adhishtanam. Adhishtanam, the substratum. Substratum of the entire universe. Because the entire the world of Maya, which we call the illusory world, it is projected. It has to be projected on something. And that something is nothing but Mahavishnu. That is the Adhishtanam. Because everything else is a delusory world. Only thing which is not delusory is the one which is supporting it. And that support, sole support, is Mahavishnu. He is the Adhishtanam. So this permanent post is called the substratum. Everything else is like the delusory ghost. What Krishna again tells, makes it very clear. He says it, Maya tatam idam sarvam, Maya tatam idam sarvam, all this is pervaded by me in Jagat avyakta murtina. That means I am in this whole world, I am spread in this world as unmanifest form. Avyakta murtina, in an unmanifest form, I am pervading the entire world. Matstani sarva bhutani, all beings dwell in me, but I do not dwell in them. Nata aham teshu avastitaha, maya tatam idam sarvam jagat avyakta murtina. Matstani sarva bhutani, nata aham teshu avastitaha. Reading in a normal manner. Maya tatamitam sarvam jagadavyakta murtina mastani sarva bhutani na chaham teshva vastitaha. Now, being the substratum of the universe, the Supreme has to be, and it is always alert and attentive to the needs of all the living and non-living beings
in this particular universe. That means alertness is denoted by the Sanskrit word apramattaha. Apramatta. Apramattaha is one who is ever attentive, always alert. That is one who has no pramada, meaning one who never commits a mistake in judgment. The Lord is the law behind all happenings in the universe. Everything else is a result. The results of all actions are always according to the quality of the actions. In administering, so that means if the administrator is not alert or if he makes a mistake, then the result will be a disaster. But the supreme director in this case, the Mahavishnu, is always alert, always attentive, always perfect, never commits any mistake in either planning or in execution. So all the actions we see around us are in perfect harmony. You cannot doubt the quality of the result. The universe is flawless. It's only because the creator is absolutely attentive. So this is the law of karma. So he is the one who never makes any mistake. Apramattaha. Whereas we human beings, we are full of pramada. We misunderstand ourselves. We mistake ourselves to be the matter equipment. We think we are the body. No, we are not the body. Body is only a projection. And this mistake is because of our ego, our false concept. We are not able to understand the Maya. Krishna proclaims in Bhagavad Gita that he is always alert and active. He says he is not required. He does not have any work to do. He has no targets. He has no particular desires. He need not. But for the welfare of the universe, to set a good example to all living beings, he is always active. And he says, if I am not active, if I am lazy, if I set a bad example, people will try to follow me and the world will perish. Utsideyuhu ime lokaha na kuryam karma chet aham sankarasya chakartasyam upahanyam ima prajaha. If I do not perform action, that is continuous action, these worlds will perish. Then Krishna says, I will be the cause of confusion of caste. Caste means people not discharging their respective responsibilities, which will lead to destruction of these people. So I am always alert. Apramattaha. He takes care of everyone. There is none to look after him. Who is looking after him? Nobody. Not required, because he is ever established in his own glory. Pratishtitaha, well established. Established in own glory. Everything in the world depends upon something else to serve as its cause. All things we perceive and experience in the world of names and forms and objects, these are merely effects. But they have their own cause. But if you trace the ultimate cause, that cause is the supreme. Because effects must necessarily depend upon the cause of their very existence. The Supreme Lord is the cause. Who is the cause of Supreme? Nobody. Because Supreme Lord is the uncaused cause. He is the ultimate cause. He is the causeless cause. Because everything else is with reference to him. So everything else is only an effect. He is the ultimate cause. He is not depending upon anything other than himself. So this is denoted by the term pratishtitaha. The self-established reality is indicated by the term pratishtitaha. So which is the last name appearing in this verse. Om Sarvesham Swastir Bhavatu, Sarvesham Shantir Bhavatu, Sarvesham पूर्णं भवतु, सर्वेषां मंगलं भवतु, ओम शांति 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 हे।